Welcome to the Uzema Health and Wellness Podcast.
Weigh in on this, and it's the conversation surrounding Brother Kirk Franklin. And I'm going to call him Brother Kirk Franklin because I love Kirk Franklin. I grew up on his music, and his energy has been infectious. I love gospel music. Do you?
Oh, absolutely. Property is one that means a lot to all of us.
Right. So he started, you know, this whole like, you know, moving gospel music into, you know, that feel good music, you know, and that's kind of what I'm trying to do with Uzema. Let's take it from one area that we're comfortable. And let's move it ever so slightly into another space and see how it's received. And lo and behold, it was phenomenal. Right.
Right.
And so you are not only, as you were given your accolades, you are a father.
Got three kids.
Three. How many sons?
My boy's 24. He just finished college. He's out on the East Coast. Mm-hmm. I got 26 in law school in Atlanta. And I got a daughter, 31. She's an orthopedic surgeon in California. So I can understand his experience. Mm-hmm. Having kids and grown kids. Like his son was 33. It's a challenge for a lot of reasons. Those are issues that I think have relevance for all of us. So we've got a lot to talk about.
Well, I'm going to stand up a little bit. My shirt says, I am Flint. Okay? And what does it say? Stone.
Used to spark the fire.
There you go. So you Flint. You Flint, Dad. You know what I'm saying? You spark the fire in your children, and they're supposed to go out and do what? Make some heat.
Good work. I agree.
Turn it up, right?
Productive for yourself, your family, your community. Absolutely.
Right. And sometimes it's not a perfect science. Would you agree?
Oh, I'd agree.
It's not a perfect science. So this resonated with me because I grew up with my father's one of nine sons. Okay. And so I was always around men talking and loved going to the barbershop, you know, with my dad. And so it resonated with me to say, wait a minute, Steve Harvey and Kevin Hart and Ricky Smiley, all of my favorites, are coming out and supporting and saying, wait a minute now, I'm a father, I have sons, I want to weigh in on this conversation. And there's some words that they're floating around that I think as a psychiatrist, I said, let me ask the doctor and see what you think, not only as a doctor, but a father. And say, you know, comment on these words that I'm hearing, not so much as the interaction between Kirk Franklin and his son, but this is an opportunity to make relevant some conversations of some words. Anger.
Right.
And abandonment. And I'm gonna pause and let you tell me some things in terms of your professionalism about that.
Right. Well, I'd say a few things that I just look forward to talking to you at more length about it today. First and foremost, I'd say that the circumstance that I witnessed or heard, like many Americans and people all around the world, is certainly disconcerting and less than optimal. And no one really wants to be around or aware of anything that's negative or adverse. And I think that my heart goes out to all sides, because probably both sides are hurting emotion in some regard. As a psychiatrist, you know, we're trained not to take sides. We spend a great deal of time trying to find some peace and contentment and some middle ground where all sides feel like they can actually win in resolving emotional and psychological conflict. Those are the words that we use in psychiatry. But I love your point, Kendra. I think the reality is I am an African-American person, a man, a father, three kids. I'm not sure how many kids Kirk Franklin has, but this is his biological son and his emotional son. And for lack of a better term, if someone's asked me who do I side with, I do father in this setting, and I'll tell you why. First and foremost, I think that all human beings are imperfect. I do believe in the Bible, and whether you're Kirk Franklin and who's involved in music, in religion or not, folks who believe in the Bible recognize the Bible makes it very clear that there's only really one perfect person ever walking on the face of this earth. I think that actually makes a lot of sense. So that individuals are imperfect and will make mistakes. They will say the wrong thing, they'll do the wrong things. That's the world we live in, and that's how the world's always been, based on the Bible that we believe in. And I try as a psychiatrist to integrate psychiatric themes, but also be a person who recognizes that what the Bible teaches us actually is a pathway for life. Mm-hmm. I think it's also clear that In life, everyone has bad days. We have bad moments. We do the wrong thing. We say the wrong thing. This idea that persons are judged by what others know about them. When we catch somebody with video or with a camera or a picture, and somehow that makes them different than everyone else who may have had a bad day or a bad moment or a bad circumstance that wasn't caught on video or television, doesn't resonate with me as a psychiatrist. The reality is, what is the individual thinking and feeling and how can they grow is what matters. Just to get so excited, as society very often does, in a very contemporaneous fashion, I think in a very publicity-oriented fashion, is probably less than optimal because it implies that someone is only bad if you know something is bad about them, if you've seen them on videotape or whatever the case may be. A celebrity is less than authentic circumstance. I think a third thing that I also add, though, is that I think that we do have different expectations in society of persons. Maybe Kirk Franklin is a huge issue because he's involved, I think, what I'll call the spiritual, the religious profession. That's how you're living. He preaches and what have you in their life, or sings, I think, a religious gospel. But that in no way should mean that individuals who choose to be involved in that profession and rightly so, and then they deserve credit for doing so, are any less amenable to difficulty and conflict than the rest of us. So the reality is there probably a lot of pain that I heard on that audio tape and a lot of difficulty on both sides. Clearly, in psychiatry, we work to get both sides to learn how to grow, how to throw water on the barbecue fire, not lighter fluid, how to decrease anger and angst, I love your term, anger and hostility, and bring people down from the heightened levels of negativism and heightened adverse emotion to some middle ground where you can make some actual gains and have better relationship growth. I think those are really the key issues for me. And whether it was Kirk Franklin, to me, he's the person on that tape, but it's really, he's like a metaphor for human beings, for parents, for fathers, trying to do difficult situations with their adult children. And they are very challenging as they were for him, they've been for me, and they've been for all fathers.
Hi, Uzima family. If you like what you're seeing and what you're hearing, subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell icon below to be notified of our recent videos. What did the doctor say?